Okay, let's turn the lights on first.
Switch that damning warning horn off, Frank. It makes me splitting headaches. Can't believe that we are stupid enough to join up on that mission. Not because of the danger. It's again in the middle of the night. Check the controls first, Frank. Start with the pedals. Full deflection to the right and full to the left. And back to neutral. Cyclic friction released. Check full movement in all directions. Collective full up. And back down. Check overhead if circuit breakers all in. Pitot heat off. Anti-collision lights on. Position lights on. Cargo release off. Wipers off. Cabin heat off. Cabin lighting set as needed. AC power switch to AC phase. DC power, main generator on. DC voltmeter to ESS bus. Non-ESS bus is set to normal on. Starter generator to start. Battery on for sure, and low RPM horn also quiet. Press fire warning test switch. Indicator light works perfect. Check caution warning lights. Test and reset. Looks good. Next step is the armament and countermeasure panel check. Everything off or safe. Jettison switch is down and covered. Governor switch set to auto and engine de-icing switch is off. Main fuel switch on. Force trim and hydraulic control to on. And chip detector switch forward and aft. Set the IFF transponder master switch to standby. Set altimeter to field elevation 130 feet. Open throttle full to flight idle. Back to ground idle. Start up the engine, Frank. Blades turning. Passing 70% N1 and stable. Starter generator to standby and inverter to main on. All gauges within normal limits. Looks good so far. Let's set up the armament and countermeasures.
Select the 7.62mm guns and make sure you select both of them. The rocket selector sets to 2 and the whole thing to safe. Set up the radio compass before we do the next step and set up the radio. Starting command frequency is 118.50 MHz. And switch the radio on, by the way. the ARC-51 set to preset 5 and transmit receive. Open throttle slowly to flight idle. I set the intercom and call Berlin headquarters. Berlin command, Wolf 2. Good morning.
Good morning, Wolf 2. Berlin command. Whatever you want to do at the crack of dawn, approve. You are the only one awake.
The early bird catches the warm command. Wolf 2, departing southbound. We take it easy.
Got the vet. Have a good flight, Wolf 2.
Okay, Frank. Take off whenever you're ready. We follow the coastline over the water down to Petuni Airport. Changing frequency to Petuni Tower.
Frequency change approved, Wolf 2.
I change frequency and call Petuni Tower. Petuni Tower, Wolf 2. Good morning.
Good morning, Wolf 2. Seems we have the same ship schedule.
That's because we are working night and day. It's a 24-hour schedule.
So, what's your intention, Wolf 2?
Only the best, of course. Wolf 2 is over Petuni Harbor, flying along the coast southbound and crossing the sea. 3113 centerline in a few minutes before following the river eastbound.
You are the only traffic module cleared to cross. Stay on frequency as long as the two we control. Frequency change and exit is approved. Entire flight, I go back to my cup of coffee.
Here's the cross, Wolf 2. Enjoy your coffee as well. I love flying at night. When the moon is shining, over the river may be a bad idea. Stay between the city lights. That's more effective. Climb to 1,000 feet. Light check. Anti-collision. Off. Standby. Off. Landing light. Off as well. Turn right and on the next valley to the left. In the moonlight, the water is just like liquid silver. It has something magical. Now to the left. From here on, it's no way without sighting coming. We also have to stay lower over the sea, 300 feet ATL maximum. I monitor torque and COT.
The cruise at the power station, can you read?
While crossing ahead, stay above 216 ATL. The reconstruction will take at least 4 more weeks, so they are still very busy down there. Too high. No more wires from now on, but be alert anyway. There may be one or the other surprise on the way up. Too high. We are perfect in time. Sandman, a group of tornadoes started right now into a low holding. So they are above the target 1 minute after we call them. Checkpoint is already restored and back in use. too high. Too high. Let's go to Fodor, right in front of us. From here on, it's getting critical. Then to the left and following that river. We need to direct to the rebel camp. Stay closer to the trees, below 200 feet ATL. If they hear us coming, or even worse, they detect us, and the direction we are coming from, we may get a warm welcome. Too high. Our course of action. First, direct overfly the flag and knock them out with the gun. The rocket launchers are at about 1 o'clock, direct behind, in about the same height. I've hit to the rocket to blast them up. The radar station is our main target. Without them, they are not able to lock up to the oncoming tornado. We have 90 seconds to do so before they overcome their surprise and we are in deep. As you already know, they are equipped with stems fired from the shoulder. So, regardless of we are successful or not, after 90 seconds, we dive into the valley northwest. Too high. COD close to maximum. COD close to maximum. Percent ESI. COD close to maximum. 45% ESI. 50% ESI. 50% PSI. 50% PSI. We will be right there, about 1 mile out. Weapons armed. Get ready for attack. The Zulu uniforms 23 flag is to the left of the tree, right on top of the hill. Too high. COT 60 seconds above limit. They are already right left. Right. You see 90 seconds above the limit. Rocket active. COT critical. Which means immediate. Radar station destroyed. Radar station destroyed. Batman, window is open. Window is open, over.
Roger that.
Let's get out of here. Immediate. Land away from the target zone. We wait for segment 3.
Wolf 2, Sandman, dream delivered.
Watch that, Sandman. Flying back to the target zone. Okay, Frank, let's take a closer look to the team. We have to be sure that all the rocket launchers are destroyed. where they have been located. But keep your eyes tight. There may be still someone able to see. Let's get out of here. Heading 275 to east. Perfect stop range. Let's fly back home. Let's step back first. Later we may climb again and fly direct back to the HQ. By the same boat. Rubble and destroy the heat flex. follow the river to the left. I call HQ. Sterling Command, Wolf 2.
Welcome back, Wolf 2. And congratulations, everybody is excited about the successful mission. And that you're still in one piece.
E2 Command, E2. Report, about 2 miles out. Wolf 2, will call. Heading 290, keep it in that direction. A little bit more to the left. I keep the light on.
Report, about 2 miles out. Sounds good. But anyway, same parking point position will do.
I think that this is confirming any damage. Not one single contact mark at this time.
Here to land at your starting point. The general expected that you've damaged the aircraft again.
What is that, Command? Take care of the cables and light poles in front of the LZ. Shut it down. Tom and Hank waiting at the HQ. We have something to celebrate.